So if you've ever worked with a harpist before, a common complaint you may have gotten is that your music is too difficult. What are you supposed to make of that? Are harpists just lazy and don't want to practice? Hi, I'm Danielle from Compose Harp, and I want to help you learn how to write for the harp with confidence. Now, regardless of the type of music you're writing, you have to write it at an appropriate level for your prospective musician or ensemble. This means you have to understand how difficult the music actually is and what it is that makes it difficult. So in this video, we're going to chat about how to determine the level of difficulty of your harp writing. Now, this doesn't mean that all your music has to be easy or you can never write anything complicated. If it's difficult, it should be for intentional musical reasons, not just because you weren't sure how hard it would actually be on the harp. So first, we'll chat about the layers of complexity or what all is actually involved in playing a given excerpt. Number two, we'll use those layers to be able to estimate difficulty. And number three, we'll chat about some guidelines for how to write appropriately for a given level. So number one, we'll talk about the layers of complexity. First is the hands themselves, the fingers. Do you have a lot of finger independence between the hands? Are the fingers all going to be playing in a row? Or are they going to be playing out of order? Out of order, especially on the harp, is far more difficult than notes that are played out of order or patterns out of order on the piano. So that adds one layer of complexity. Also, if you're having to jump between sections where you can't place notes together, that adds another layer. So quick jumps where you don't have a lot of time to prepare the jump is far more difficult than if you have a rest or time to be able to look at the string, figure out your place, and then place on the harp. So any jumps that are written in the music are going to increase the level of difficulty. The second layer is the relationship between the hands. Are the hands working together? Are they playing more or less the same patterns, the same intervals? Are they working together? Or are they working independently of each other? If they're independent, it's going to be far more difficult than if they're working simultaneously. The third layer is the complexity of the pedal work. So if you have a lot of rapidly changing pedals, that's going to increase the difficulty level of a given passage. Now, if you put all of these three elements together, if you have lots of finger independence and jumps within hands and a lot of independence within the two hands and they're both doing different things, plus you stack a lot of pedal changes, that's going to create a very difficult score. Whereas if you'll keep one of those levels simple, for instance, minimal pedal changes while the hands are doing different things, or if there's a lot of pedals, have the hands work together. That's going to minimize the difficulty level and make it far more realistic. Now, on top of that, these specific harp things, you also have other musical things. How quickly is the harmonic rhythm changing? Are we having to read new harmonies every beat? Is the harmonic rhythm slower where we only have a new harmony every measure? That's adds some complexity. Rhythm, how intricate are the rhythms? Even individual hands between the hands, or just in general, are there a lot of really tricky rhythms? That's going to increase the difficulty versus something that is a little bit more straightforward. And then last, if there's some counterpoint going on where there's two completely independent phrases that all have to be phrased, and on and on and on. So the more complex factors you integrate, the simpler each of those factors will have to be in order to be playable. So second is how to determine the difficulty level. So the first has to do with the actual layers themselves. What all do you have going on in a given passage? The second is how long is this passage? Is the difficult passage going to be, you know, a measure or two where you have really difficult handwork plus hand independence plus a lot of pedals? That might be realistic for a couple measures at a time, but perhaps not for an entire piece. So third, guidelines for writing. Now this is going to be heavily dependent on, you know, the ensemble you're working with, the harpist you're working with. Are you writing for a high school ensemble? Are you writing for an amateur orchestra? Are you writing for a professional orchestra? Are you writing for a professional soloist? But the goal is to actually think through these layers and be really intentional, because we don't want to write music that's difficult just for the sake of being difficult, or difficult just because you weren't really aware of what's going on. You want to write difficult music that's as simple as possible given the layers that you have. So as far as the guidelines for writing, you really just want to think about the layers that you have involved in your music and work with that at the appropriate level. So if you're writing for a middle school or high school student, you want to keep it really simple. Maybe have two complex layers. Make sure that you don't have really complicated rhythms with a lot of pedal changes going on. If you're writing for a professional ensemble, that can obviously be a little bit more complex, but be really intentional about how you're doing it. Solo works, you can have a little bit more leeway, especially if you're working with a specific soloist where you know their strengths. So for instance, most harpists aren't really great with one-handed trills, but there's a few harpists out there that are incredible at them and they love to show them off. So if you're working with one of those, add in that layer. But for most harpists, you won't want to do really complex trills with a bunch of other stuff going on. So all that to say, take a look at the passage, and I challenge you to take a look at some of your past writing examples and really write out all the layers of complexity that you have going on and see if you could estimate the given level. So I hope this is helpful. If you enjoyed this video, please be sure to give me a thumbs up. That really helps. And leave me a comment. Let me know what you think. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. I have lots of more videos coming for you all. Talk to you all next time. Hey, thank you so much for watching this video. If you found it helpful but feel like you need a little bit of practical assistance, you should check out the free workshop I'm hosting on April 27th, 28th, and 29th. The workshop is entitled From Awkward to Effortless, Write Music That Harpists Want to Play. You can register at daniellekuntz.com/free workshop or use the link in the description below. I hope to see you there.